Pittsburgh, the site tonight for the Penguins and Islanders. Penguins returning from a long road trip, and certainly it is going to be an emotional night there when you think about what happened in Pittsburgh over the weekend. Joining us now to preview the game is Dan Potash. And Dan, the Penguins are paying tribute to the victims of this weekend's tragic events tonight. Tell us more about their efforts.
Well, let me tell you, EJ, that Pittsburgh is strong. Pittsburgh strong. It was hard for us to really wrap our heads around what happened on Saturday while we were 2,500 miles away in Vancouver. But as soon as we arrived back home here on Sunday night, it did not take long for me to feel the love on every street corner within this city. It actually began yesterday, if you will, with the Penguins hosting a blood drive here at PPG Paints Arena, where over 250 people showed up to donate, which in turn, if I'm correct, can help at least 700 people or more in need of blood. It will continue tonight at the turnstiles. When people enter the arena, they can donate funds. And also, the Penguins will be wearing special patches on their jersey with the Penguin logo that says strength.
It's stronger than hate. We have it up right here.
Stronger than hate. Yeah. Excuse me. Stronger than hate. Thank you. Forgive me. I lost my train of thought there. Stronger than hate. Every jersey will be autographed and then auctioned off through November 13th. And if fans want to donate to the cause or actually bid on those jerseys, they can do so at treeoflife.givesmart.com. So nice to see that the Penguins are doing their best to rally, but a lot of love being felt in the city over the last few days.
Yeah, no question. It was a just a tragic event, and it'll be an emotional night there in the building, and great to see the Penguins are doing what they can to help in this time of healing in the city of Pittsburgh. As we look at the game tonight, the Pens head into tonight fresh off that perfect 4-0 Canadian road trip. What contributed to the successful trip both on and off the ice?
Well, you know what? They were looking for an opportunity to bond before they left town on this 12-day trip and get a few wins. Well, they certainly were able to bond, and they got a few wins. And in talking to the guys as the games came about and we moved forward on the trip, they talked about simplifying their game and finding a way to simplify their game, and they certainly did that more than on one occasion. And before we left town, there was a lot of talk, you know, amongst fans and maybe some members of the media, when someone like Sidney Crosby would score a goal, or Patrick Hornquist, or Brian Rust, some guys that were really part of the offense that showed up throughout last season. Well, once they started to score on this trip, they continued to score, or at least continued to make their presence felt. And by simplifying their game, they were strong on pucks, attacked, and they were relentless in so many different ways that it reminded me of the kind of Penguin team that really relied on speed and took advantage of their speed over the last couple of seasons. That combined with several days off and an opportunity to bond in Banff, which, by the way, was my first visit and is absolutely spectacular. It was really cool to see them come together. I know that the trip ended on a difficult note, but again, much like the fans here and people here in the city, they came together as a team, finished their trip strong, and they certainly hope to continue to do that tonight against the Islanders.
Matt Murray, he was a big part of the road trip. How has he been so dominant since returning from another concussion?
Yeah, that's a great question. He continues to say he's just playing his game. I think it has a lot to do with the fact that he, first of all, he's an excellent goaltender. The way he stands up in the crease, the way he tracks down pucks. He's got a pretty good defensive unit working in front of him, led by Brian Dumoulin and Chris Letang, and hopefully we'll see Chris Letang tonight. But that top pairing has been so effective in so many different ways. But he just sees the puck really well. He's feeling it. It reminds us of the kind of goaltender that the Penguins had when they made their run throughout the playoffs in each of the last few seasons. When he's healthy, he's one of the best in the game. And right now he's feeling extremely strong. And let's not forget about Casey DeSmith, who is the backup and stepped in for him and also posted a shutout before we flew back home in Vancouver. And he dedicated that win to the city of Pittsburgh. So right now, as far as goaltending is concerned, the Penguins are feeling pretty good with Matt Murray and Casey DeSmith.
Derek Brassard, Chris Letang, they're two big names on the injury watch. What's the latest on their status, and what's the impact of their absence if they can't go?
Well, let's start with Chris Letang, who's probably off to the best start of his National Hockey League career. And it's probably because of the fact that he's healthy after what happened last season. He's really just settled into his game. I talked about the connection with Brian Dumoulin. He's been paired with him before, but has just found a different level to play at. And it's so great to see that. Of course, he's a quarterback on the power play. Moves the puck really well, but has really settled in. He's a game-time decision for tonight, so the Penguins would obviously miss him. As for Derek Brassard, they're still kind of going back and forth between playing on the wing and playing at center. Now, in his last game against Calgary, when the Penguins put up 9 goals, he was on Sidney Crosby's wing, and had three assists. So the thought was, okay, let's see him build on that. But because of his injury, he's still not going to be able to play tonight. But Dominic Simone, in turn, who's played really well on the fourth line, another young, fast guy, has stepped in and played extremely well alongside Sidney Crosby. So we'll probably see that matchup in place of Derek Brassard on the left wing, or at least on one of the wings, tonight. So it's unfortunate that Derek has been slowed by injury. But again, I would like to think that finding some consistency in this system, which he was hoping to do coming out of training camp, will be beneficial to him once he regains his health.
All right, Dan, before we let you go, we know you're a big Halloween guy. Under the circumstances tonight, obviously you're not going to dress up. In other years you have, and we're showing some of the footage here. What would you have been this year?
You know what? I'll go ahead and let the cat out of the bag. I was destined to be Ogie Oglethorpe, and I had it all set and ready to go. Came up a little bit short last year in getting the Oglethorpe jersey, missed Halloween, so I was really looking forward to presenting that costume this year. But you know what? It'll age well again for another year, and I'll make sure I bring it out, and I will talk to you guys before that game next year on Halloween.
All right. Well, we look forward to that, and you're right. It will age well because, hey, Ogie Oglethorpe, I mean, he lives forever. So it's perfect. Dan, thanks a lot for the time today. There you go. Thanks for the time today, buddy. We appreciate it.